usually on the other side of that level of failure or that level of challenge is just the beginning of the next best thing, the next best chapter, the next best you. I had an unbelievable interview I did this week. We wanted to do it for clients, and our tagline at Freedom Street Partners is life, wealth, optimization. And wealth comes second for a reason. You can't optimize wealth without having the life portion first. And so we always look for really unbelievable, amazing people to interview or to talk to or to really show our client base and all of you out there that watch our videos. And I had the pleasure to interview Jim Harshaw. Jim is amazing. He just finished his 300th podcast. And if you haven't found him, his podcast is Success Through Failure. It's amazing. 300, number 300, number 200. He does a recap. So they're great podcasts to go out and really understand what he stands for. But here's a couple of points that I just wanted to bring up, some really cool ideas. When we started talking about success through failure, it so resonated with me when we talk about the world of money and investing, because so many people are afraid to fail. And really, when you're investing, it's risk versus reward. Right? And the more risk you take, the more reward you potentially could have. But there's no guarantees in anything. It's like anything we do in life. If we bet on ourselves, we may fail. But the fear of failure often keeps people from ever actually betting on themselves. And Jim's story is one that I really recommend that you go out and you listen to, because he was an All-American wrestler. He built amazing business. He now coaches professionals and business associates all across the country. And he also runs one amazing podcast. But as I build Jim up, what I also got to listen to were traits of success through certain moments of failure, and then values and qualities that people possess when they find that real level of success. And they correlated to our industry. They correlated to every industry. So what was really cool about the success through failure mindset was just really exploring the trajectory that most people go on. They're usually doing certain things when they find themselves to be most successful. When they're at their best weight or at their best physical attributes, they feel really, really good because they're doing certain things. They're eating healthy. They're exercising. They're disciplined, right? And then when they're off of that, they find this craziness, this chaos. It's really about restoring order to some of the chaos in our lives in the areas that we need it. And so this could go in anything. I just mentioned health, but think about money. You know, sometimes just organizing all the things we're doing, evaluating where we are today, where do we want to go, how are we going to get there, and laying out a plan, having a plan that is flexible, you can pivot, but having a plan, a blueprint, if you will, provides a chapter to success. It provides a road path to success. It just does. But it really is built on the first thing, which is the organizational structure of your plan. And when you have that plan, you could start to identify what that vision really was and what you're aiming to get to, but it's not being afraid to fail that starts with that. And guess what you're going to do all along the way if you're really great? Fail. I think back in business, so this is a really interesting thing. You know, recently I've been putting together a book for the past year and a half, almost 2 years. And when you talk about failure, the first question I was asked when I was talking to the publisher was to think about moments in my life where I had failed. And I spent 2 or 3 days going through these moments. And I was talking to my wife about it, and she was adding moments of failure that I had forgotten, and not in a bad way, but a really great way. Like, wow, you overcame this, and we overcame this as a family, and these were challenges we had. And when you start to look at all those things, they're so big in that moment, but they're so small when you're thinking of the whole body of work. We use it in the stock market all the time. You look at the chart of investing in 1980 until now, and you look at how the market has performed okay? This is not an example of something you should or shouldn't invest in or do, but it's just truth, right? Something on this big mountain chart, you see all these big little divots, but they rise rapidly to this big mountain chart. But along the way, if I magnify the moments, they're huge. If you look at 2008, 2009, it was huge. If you look at March of 2020, when COVID first erupted in the United States, it was huge, huge drops that feel like the end of the world in those moments. They're just the beginning of something great. Usually on the other side of that level of failure or that level of challenge is just the beginning of the next best thing, the next best chapter, the next best you. What is it for you? What are you holding back on? Where are we at right now where failure is just something we have to experience to get to the other side of the true level of success? We do a lot of videos. They're not all great, okay? I've made lots of mistakes. I'm not always perfect. In fact, I love the imperfection of our videos. Sometimes I put stuff out that probably could be perfected a lot better. But I do so because I like watching myself fail and succeed each time a little differently. When I do these videos, sometimes I fail right in the middle of it and I stop and I pause and I know that we'll edit it and I move right back onto the thought. In the beginning, it might have derailed me, might have derailed the video. They seem huge in the moment, but the truth is the opportunity zone that presents itself through failure is way bigger than anything you can imagine. So as we look at coming off a tough year, as you look at changes and challenges in your relationships, look at the failure and examine what great mountain is right in front of you. What great mountain exists that this becomes just a divot, just a divot, just something that we tripped on, not something we fell in. How can we build on that? So I love talking to Jim. I started this off by talking about success through failure, and there was so much that I wanted to talk about. And I'm going to have a couple of different videos that we can do that really dive deeper onto some of the ideas that we talked about because we hit it off because his mindset is so good. It's so good. There's a reason why he's interviewed some of the greatest people out there right now, from Tim Ferriss to all-American athletes, to people that have done things that you only dream of doing. I mean, the stories he told on this were awesome, and I'm not going to ruin it because I want you to see it. So make sure you try to find that, or we'll link it in the comments below so you can watch it. But I just want you to understand that good humans, good successful individuals have learned their biggest opportunities come from failure. Don't be afraid of it. Thanks for joining me.